Cedia, coming to you live all the way from Times Square. And with me, I have
Hallie
and
Izzy.
And would you guys consider yourself hard workers?
Very. That's literally the only reason why we're here.
Yeah, we literally just got an internship at Yale, and so
yeah,
you kind of have to be hardworking to do that.
Last night they told us the less sleep that we get, the better that we'll work. And if we burn holes in our eyes from being on our computer for like 7 to 2 hours straight, that they like that. So.
Which is pretty much what I'm used to doing at college anyways, like 24, 48-hour study days.
So what motivates you guys to go above and beyond what most people would ever do?
Honestly, I don't know. There's just, I feel like there's some part of my brain that's like messed up, and I just have the thing in my head that I have to be better than everybody else, and if I don't like accomplish everything that's in my head, there's going to be someone else doing that and living my dream, and that just absolutely can't happen.
Yeah,
that's what I think.
I just like the feeling of being accomplished, you know what I mean, like when you finish something, and like I have a 4.0 at college, and just like that feels so nice every time, like on holidays I get to go home and be like, yeah, I have a 4.0 in literally college. So it's just a nice, gratifying feeling.
You know? Flex it.
Yeah,
flex it.
Honestly, you guys work so hard. You deserve every award, accomplishment. Like, you deserve to be hyped up, you know?
Yeah, no problem.
Have you ever gotten, like, haters along the way?
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
How do you deal with it?
I use it as my motivation. I lift a lot, so sometimes I'll think about the people that hate me, and then I pretend they're all watching me. And anytime I do something good, it's kind of like, fuck it to them. Like, that's how I see it.
Yeah, that's true, that's true. So, what is your strongest for bench press?
I ripped 205 for 3 last week.
205 for 3, oh my god. And if you accomplished everything in the world, if no matter what, you would always be number one, what would you guys do?
Ooh.
Yeah.
That's a hard one.
I think that I would be a chef.
Oh, okay.
If I could like not fail and always accomplish it, I would be a chef. I love to cook, but I'm so bad.
I'm sorry. So you interned at Yale, but you don't think you can make it as a chef? You're like the top 1%.
But we're up there. We're at Yale for strength and conditioning.
Yeah.
So cooking, strength, lifting weights. Little opposite.
I was going to say, like, solve America's, like, political climate problems, but that sounds a lot more... I was like, am I going to get deep on here?
You're like, let's do anything political. I'm like, I want to cook.
Activism.
Oh, my God. I think you guys, like, you've worked so hard. You're capable of so much. There's nothing that you can fail at. If you want to be a chef, you're going to be, like, a Michelin star chef.
We'll teach yourselves right now.
Might as well.
We'll teach ourselves.
Live your best life.
Yeah, we're going to. That's why we're here.
So... question about politics.
Okay.
If you wanted to fix the problems, would you do it by running for office or being one of the richest people that gets to kind of influence the people that run for office?
Oh, definitely. I mean, I'm kind of under the belief that the people that run for office, it's kind of, I mean, it's important, but I don't think that's the person that has all of the power. It's the money is where the power is. And I think that there's people that we will never know the names of, that we will never see, that's kind of controlling. I have a very, like, I have a whole conspiracy in my head about this, that we're never going to know, that there's these select people that are running everything and everybody else is kind of those pawns. So
do you guys think we're all pawns right now, living someone else's life?
I think we're in a simulation.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
This is a glitch in the simulation that we're here right now, because I don't know how we're here.
Exactly.
Guys, after they watch this, we're so screwed.
No, I'm like...
How do we win?
They don't know my last name. They don't know my last
Literally,
name, so it's fine.
We should put our mask on.
Yeah, put your mask on.
How do we win?
Yeah.
We have to beat the game. That's what we're doing right now. That's why we're working hard.
Yeah.
Maybe that's the motivation.
I mean, your eyes aren't bleeding yet, so that makes me happy, you know? Yeah.
Fingers crossed they don't, but if they do, at least it's for a good
time. That's actually our motivation why we're doing what we're doing, is to just beat our simulation.
Yeah.
Exactly. Break the cycle.
Yeah.
So if you had no influence from anybody in the world, how would you live your life right now? Nobody you know in the world knows who you are. You're never going to meet somebody that can love you. It's just your life alone.
What we're doing right now, literally what we're doing right now,
we
moved here from the Midwest without our families. We don't know a single person in the Northeast. We met each other 3 days ago, and we've just been, we came here for fun on a train. and we're going around town doing whatever we feel like, talking to strangers like we're doing right now. So I would do what I'm doing right now.
Yeah. So how did you decide to live the life that was really meant for you when everyone else has other demands and like wants of you?
Oh, that's easy. I literally just don't care about other people's opinions.
Yeah.
I'm like a mega hippie. And so it's like you find your inner peace and then you just don't care. So you just do what you
meditation
love.
And crystals.
Yeah.
So how did you find your inner peace?
Meditation and leaving my hometown and basically just like realizing that this is like not permanent. Literally nothing is permanent. So like why would I not come to New York on a whim? Like why would I not eat that brownie? You know what I mean? Like I could die tomorrow.
I mean, I kind of agree with that. If you think about it, it's good or bad. Nothing actually matters, like, in this world. Like, 100 years from now when we're all dead, the fact that the chance that people are going to remember your name are very, very slim. So you can look at that in a negative way, or you can look at that in a positive way to just be like, fuck it, and do what you want to do. Don't waste your time. Just go after what you want, because in the end, like, you burning a bridge with somebody that you don't really care about is not going to matter.
All right, guys, I'm going to go burn some bridges.
Yeah.
This is CBS signing off GLE TV.